Yeah. Amen. Lord. attention to this morning's gospel reading. You may have noticed that it's a story of a young man who was blind. And while he sat by the side of the road and he asked Christ to have mercy on him, those who knew him and those who were in the area tried to stop him and said for him to be quiet. And the more they asked him to be quiet and silent, he continued to cry out and to call upon Christ to heal him and to have mercy on him. For when Christ gave his mercy, from him also came grace. And Christ approached this young man and said to him, "What do you want?" He said, "I want to see. I wish to have my sight." And Christ said, "Receive it then, for your faith has made you well. Your faith has saved you." You see, sometimes in our lives, Christians, we have to continue and we have to persist. We have to be constant in what we're doing. We can't give up hope. We have to be like that blind man who continues to cry out and call upon Christ and ask for mercy and salvation. Certainly you know that life is filled with problems and challenges and issues. They don't just disappear. But we are healed by his blood and by his stripes, as the scriptures say, when we continue to call out to him and when we ask him to heal us. It is there at that point in life when he enters our own lives. And he says, because of your faith and because of your constant appeal, because of your desire to be well, I indeed will heal you. And he asks you and he asks me individually, what is it that you need? What do you want? For Christ, although knows what we want and what we need, wants us to verbalize it, to comprehend our reliance and our necessity of him in our lives. He wants us to know that we depend on him to heal us. And indeed, he heals us and returns to us our sight and he gives us our health. But are we like that blind young man who acknowledges God's grace? That individual who was blind sitting by the road who was healed? Do we acknowledge God's glory and his grace and his gift to us? Or do we just go on with life, continuing as it was in the past? There is a hymn which I'm sure you may have heard called Amazing Grace. And it says, "I once was blind, but now I see." I think many of us are blind in life because of our issues and our challenges, and we don't see the beauty of God's world and his creation. We're blind to the problems that surround us because our life is so self-centered. And yet when you look to Christ and take upon you his yoke and you take upon yourselves his life and his vision, you're no longer blind to so many things, but you see the world in a different way. Christ today reaches out to you and to me, just like he did to that young man, and he will heal you. Just as he wants to heal me. He wants to heal us of our problems and our issues. He wants to make us whole so we know that he is alive and real, so that his grace might fill our hearts and we might glorify God's holy name. Μεταξύ των πολλών εικόνων είναι βεβαίως και η εικόνα του Αγίου Νεκταρίου. Του Θαυματουργού. Και ξέρετε μήπως ότι δίπλα στον Άγιο Νεκτάριο ήταν και οι μοναχές. Και η πρώτη καθηγουμένη, η ξένοι ήταν τυφλοί. Και εκείνη σαν τον Άγιο Νεκτάριον έγραψε ποίηματα. Και τα δικά της τα ποίηματα λένε με στίχους ότι διότι με τύφλωσα τα μαρτήματά μου και σαν τυφλή τάλεμα χάνω τα βήματα μου. Δεν βλέπω η ταλέπορος Θεέ μου που βαδίζω, που στέκω, που ευρίσκομαι, ξένοι δεν γνωρίζω. Νομίζω πολλές φορές, αγαπητοί μου αδελφοί, και εμείς είμαστε τυφλοί. Όχι με τα όματα, τα μάτια του σώματος, αλλά τα της ψυχής. Όχι σαν των νεαρών στην σημερινή περικοπή, αλλά σε κάθε αμαρτωλόν άνθρωπο. Και εμείς πολλές φορές χάνουμε τον δρόμο μας, γιατί και εμείς τυφλοί που είμαστε, δεν γνωρίζουμε που βαδίζουμε και ξεφεύγουμε από τον δρόμο του Κυρίου και τον δρόμο της σωτηρίας. Αλλά συνέχεια ο Χριστός, το φως το αληθινό, εκείνος που ήρθε να σώσει την ανθρωπότητα, στέκεται και μας ανακαλεί και μας φωνάζει. Και λέει, όπως είπε και σε εκείνον τον τυφλό, η πίστη σας σας έσωσε. Αλλά χρειάζεται να πιστεύουμε ολόκληρη την καρδιά, με ολόκληρο το πνεύμα, να είμαστε σωστοί και πιστοί χριστιανοί. Όχι μην να είμαστε χρειαροί στη ζωή μας, ως συνήθως είμαστε. Σήμερα κοίταζα πάνω στην αγιογραφία που έχετε βάλει και μάλιστα τελευταία και είδα τον Άγιο Νικηφόρο τον Λεπρό. Είδα τον Άγιο Άνθιμο της Χίου, τον πνευματικό πατέρα του Αγίου Νικηφόρου. Θυμήθηκα και τον Άγιο Βασίλειο με τα προβλήματα του που μέχρι που ήταν 50 ετών είχε χάσει όλα τα δόντια του και δυσκολευόταν να περπατήσει. Αλλά αυτοί οι άνθρωποι δεν έχασαν ποτέ τον δρόμο της πίστης. Η Αγία Ματρόνα της Ρωσίας, που ήταν και εκείνη τυφλή, δεν έχασε τον δρόμο και δεν πήγε ούτε αριστερά ούτε δεξιά. Αλλά στη βασιλική είναι εκείνη την οδόν που βαδίζουμε κι εμείς να ανέβουμε τα σκαλοπάτια της ζωής με την πίστη και με τον υδρότα της πίστεως, να ανέβουμε στη Βασιλεία των Ουρανών. Προχθές που ήμουν στον Άγιο Αντώνιο, μια μικρή εκκλησία που έχουμε στο Λονδίνο, είπα στον κόσμο ότι ο Άγιος Αντώνιος δεν μας άφησε συγγράμματα. Δεν μας άφησε κηρύγματα και λόγους σαν τον Χρυσόστομο και τον Γρηγόριο. Ο Άγιος Αντώνιος μας άφησε το παράδειγμα, τους προφορικούς λόγους και τη διδασκαλία του. Γι' αυτό και αυτοί οι Άγιοι που στολίζουν τον λαό, μερικοί ναι μεν άφησαν συγγράμματα και κηρύγματα και βιβλία, αλλά άλλοι άφησαν μόνο ένα το παράδειγμα και το βίωμα, γιατί γνώρισαν από κοντά τον Χριστό. Και εκείνοι που γνωρίζουν από κοντά τον Χριστό, κάπως σαν εκείνο τον τυφλό, βλέπουν πάλι και βλέπουν την ζωή λίγο διαφορετικά. Δεν ασχολούνται με την αμαρτία και την πίκρα, με τα προβλήματα, αλλά βλέπουν την ζωή και τον κόσμο με αγάπη, με την ίδια αγάπη που είχε και έχει ο Χριστός. Και εύχομαι ο Χριστός, εκείνος που επίησε το θαύμα τότε, να ποιήσει πάλι θαύματα σήμερα. Όχι τόσα του σώματος, αλλά περισσότερα για την ψυχή. Γιατί εκείνος θεραπεύει τον άνθρωπο, και μάλιστα τον άνθρωπο σαν εκείνο τον τυφλό συνέχεια φώναζε Κύριε ελέησον. Εκεί βρίσκουμε και μία βάση για την προσευχή. Κύριε Ιησού Χριστέ Υιέ Θεού, ελέησον με τον αμαρτωλό. Να μας ελεήσει όλους ο Χριστός και να μας φωτίζει και να χαρίζει δύναμη και κουράγιο σε όλους να συνεχίσουμε τον αγώνα μας. May Christ, the one who healed the blind man, pour out his grace upon all of us, so that we might too say, one day I was blind, but now I see. So we might regain our composure as Christians. So we might know really how we are supposed to live. Because if we live as Christians and as the people of God, we would all really love one another. Not with words, but in truth. And to love God means to love another person. And to love God means to forget and to forgive and to embrace each and every individual as Christ embraces us. In these days of the new year, may God indeed pour out his grace upon you, this community, your families, and all the world, and we may come to know him like that blind young man did, and may we sing his praises and his glory. Amen. Don't worry about your son. Let him play, let him sing, let him celebrate in the church. This is his home. Are you happy in church? That's all I want, is for you to be happy in church and to show these other people here that you're happy and that you smile. You know, old people have to be reminded sometimes to smile. That's why you have to remind me too, because I'm old, with a white beard and white hair. Bien. Yeah. That's a mess.
Όπως είπε το κράτος του πάντων ευθυγατώμενοι, συνδόξαν να μένουν το Πατρί και το Υιό και το Άγιο Πνεύμανι, νυν και αεί και εις αιώνας των αιώνων.
Thank you.
Πάνε προς Κυρίς μεν Άγιον, Κύριον Ιησού το μόνον ονομάζει, τον Σταυρός Χριστέ προσύνουν και την Αγία Φωνάση συμπνούμε και δοστάζει. Στην αριθρεώς ημών αμφίλων τον ονομάζω το πάντα, δεύτε πάντε σε Χριστή προσμίζει και
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all ages, light of light, true God of true God, begotten, not created, of one essence with the Father, through whom all things were made, who for us meant and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became man. He was crucified for us under Pontius Pilate and suffered and was buried, and he rose on the third day according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead. His kingdom shall have no end. And in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Creator of life, who proceeds from the Father, who together with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who spoke through the prophets, in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church, I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the age to come. Amen.
Tomen Carlos!
Cred într-unul Dumnezeu, Tatăl Atotputernic, Făcătorul Cerului și al Pământului, al tuturor celor văzute și nevăzute, și într-unul Domnul Iisus Hristos, Fiul lui Dumnezeu, unul născut, care din Tatăl s-a născut mai înainte de toți vecii. Lumină de lumină, Dumnezeu adevărat din Dumnezeu adevărat. Născut de anul făcut, cea de o ființă cu Tatăl din care toate se bucură, care pentru noi oamenii și pentru a noastră mântuire s-a pogorât din cer și s-a întâmplat de la Duhul Sfânt și din Fecioara Maria și s-a făcut om. Și s-a răstănit pentru noi în zilele lui Pontiu Pilat și a pătimit și s-a îngropat și a înviat a treia zi după Scripturi și s-a înălțat la ceruri și și-a de dreapta Tatălui și iarăși va să vină cu slava să judece vii și morții, a cărui împărăție nu va avea sfârșit, și într-un Duhul Sfânt, Domnul de viață Păcătorului, care din Tatăl procede, cel ce împreună cu Tatăl și cu Fiul este închinat și slăvit, care a venit prin proroci, într-o sfântă să apărâncească și apostolească biserică, mărturisească în botez pe iertarea păcatelor, aștept învierea morților și viața veacului ceva să fie.
Stomen calos, stomen metafor, proșomen din agia în afară, which is shed for you and for many
for the remission of sins. Fiat ex a tu pandes, tuto estito emamul, totis genis via ficis, to iperimon ke poloniki nomenon, isafes in amartion. Εν ειρήνη, σον εν δημονία, μακροημερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας.
Εν πρώτης μνήσθητε, Κύριε, του Αρχιεπισκόπου ημών Νικήτα, ον χάρισε τες Αγίες σου Εκκλησίες εν ειρήνη, σον εν δημον υγεία, μακροημερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθείας.
Εν πρώτης μνήσθητη, Κύριε, του Επισκόπου ημών Νικήτα, ον χάρισε τες Αγίες Εκκλησίες εν ειρήνη, σον εν τιμονιά μακροημερεύοντα και ορθοτομούντα ομούντα των λόγων της εις αληθεία.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, now and forever, world without end.
И да будут милости велика Бога, спаса нашего Иисуса Христа, со всеми вами. Αξίωσον ημάς δέσποτα με τα παρησίας ακατακρίτως τολμάν επικαλείστε σε τον επουράνιον Θεόν Πατέρα και λέγει.
The kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever and unto the ages of ages. Together with thy most holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, world without end.
Amen. The Agia Tis Agis, the holy gift for the holy people of God.